Alright. So the first thing on this little trip here is the foundations over here. And there is a hidden foundation as well. It's a lesser known one. The hidden foundation is further up around those rocks. So, not even a 5-minute hike, and we're at the first spot. A lot of people around this area that use this window frame here for photos. I've done it myself, but you'll see this view a lot in photos from this area. This right here is almost fell. This is one of the shots I've taken before. Get the Joshua tree in the window frame. That's about it for this area. I've gone exploring around the area and nothing else around here. Now we'll make our way up to the corner of those rocks. Right in that area is where the first vehicle is. This is like a grave marker or what. See a few more rocks there. I know somewhere, that might be what they were talking about, but somewhere out here is a grave. And like I said, that might be it. I'm not sure. Alright, so we're at the tip of these rocks now, and right up here is the first car. This is another big photograph area. There she is. and onward. And I don't know if you can see it from here. There is a windmill over there. It's behind this big bush right now. Kind of see it. Have to play some I Spy to see it though. Blends in pretty well. But we can hit that trail on the way back. So that other foundation is back that way. I've only been to it once. Even though I've been to this hike quite a few times. And a lot of people don't know it, but ways off from the trail, I think it's from like the windmill, which is right over there, out that way. It's like a mile hike from there up through the canyon. There's a few mines. But way back up in there, there's like two or three mines back there, and there's a little like rock thing, structure built back there as well. I won't disclose my secrets on how I found it. It's actually how I find quite a bit of stuff. Including this foundation that I didn't know about. Found it the same way that I found that. So, I don't know if I missed the trail. There is a slight, small trail that goes to it. This place didn't used to be blocked off. You used to be able to go inside. Got the tracks that go up the top of it. Oops. And you can't see it from here, but there's all kinds of engravings on the wood inside. Alright, let's try this again. I don't know where the battery died at. But so here's the second vehicle. I'm not sure why they got this laid out. I don't remember it being laid out before. This thing open. Yeah. There's some little cage thing back here. Or fence, not sure what that was. See part of it there. And there, it looks like somebody's made a trail that way, but I do not believe there's anything else past this. There is another truck in the trees over here. Yeah, that's bright. And if you want to look at that, just go ahead and pause the video. Truck is down there in the trees. Get past the little cat claws there. And I've got photos of this one, some that I've edited. Pretty cool. Thank you. So really the only thing left is you got the windmill down this way. Actually, let's see what this thing is over here. See this little block? That's probably all it is. Just a concrete block. Yeah. Concrete block. Anyway, so we got the windmill down that way. And then there's like a... there used to be a carved rock. Now it's a like a makeshift thing so that the original didn't get destroyed, or was destroyed, something or other. And then to try and find that foundation that I couldn't find. Some rocks. Found it, guys. Do a little exploring. And that is probably about 6 foot, maybe a few inches taller. That's how deep that is. Whew. All right, so that's my second time finding it now.